guys. I'm Matt Porter. Just going to introduce myself. I've been bodybuilding competitively for the last, since 04, so about 7 years now. And I'm going to be entering the Emerald Cup, actually, for the second time. The first year I entered it was 2005 as a teenager. Haven't touched the show since due to timing and competing in other shows and not thinking I was up to caliber. So this is my first year coming back into open classes and looking to have fun and hopefully do my best. So this has probably been the most difficult prep I've probably had in my entire life, just because my work schedule, taking on clients on the side as well, which isn't my main job, and then also just being entrenched in work basically and trying to, you know, worry about other people and then also worry about myself at the same time. It's been very difficult. Your body is different each year too, so my body is responding a little differently this year. This year I actually had to do cardio, which I never really did a lot of, maybe 20 minutes max a couple times a week during my other preps, but this year I got to an hour a day, you know, did sprints, just doing unorthodox things I never really had to do. Maybe that's because I'm sedentary now. I work at an office 10, 12 hours a day, so, you know, your metabolism is a little different, but very tough prep, a lot of hardships and stuff along the way, but feel pretty good now, one day out. The training always changes. I do 3 week cycles for the most part, and that could be 3 weeks of German volume training, 10 sets of 10. It could be, the next 3 weeks could be giant sets. I just believe the body gets really well adapted. The human body is obviously the most adaptable thing in the world, so I think change is always good, and I think 3 weeks is a really good time frame. And so, like I said, either German volume training, giant sets, drop sets, compound sets, and then I do something where I do rest pause, like a DC training. I do rest pause sets into a quadruple drop set from that, something I kind of made up. Maybe we can film it sometime, but just things like that every 3 weeks. Off season varies as well. Once again, I do change things up maybe every 5 to 6 weeks in the off season and really just try to focus on the core meat and potato, you know, movements, heavy as possible within reason, because I care about longevity and my joints and everything do hurt. So just compound movements, sometimes straight sets. And then for shocking purposes, I'll still do even giant sets, even in the off season here and there, depending on where my nutrition's at, carbohydrates are at. So it really just depends. I'm big on shocking the body. Pre-contest diet this year has been the hardest diet. I tell everybody, I was making a joke with my my office guy that shares an office with me, that the last 4 weeks probably gonna be like fish and water, and that's it. Like, I truly believe, we'll backtrack a little bit. It started off with certain normal things, you know, steak here and there, chicken here and there. Carbs are always low. I don't believe in a high carbohydrate diet. I'm sedentary. I work an office job. Healthy fats were implemented. As the weeks get closer, as everybody knows, calories usually should come down. Basically, the last 4 weeks was fish and water, man. It was I bought like 60 pounds of cod and ate that and stomached as well as I could. It was got really tough towards this last week. And I don't really eat vegetables because I use a really good green fruits product from rxway.com. It covers all my phytonutrients. And that's pretty much it. I believe that most competitors can get in very good condition on either fats and protein or carbs and protein. But to go from good condition to great condition, I think every competitor, regardless of metabolism, the last 3 weeks probably needs to cut out carbs and fat and really suffer and go on an only protein diet to go from good to great. And there's a difference. That little 2% or whatever does make a difference on stage. So that's just, it's been tough. I can motivate myself, but I get more inspired by people I respect saying things that are encouraging. Actually, I'm probably more motivated by local people that I know than like pros, you know, IFBB pros you watch in DVDs or whatever, because they're real people that I know, like in the area, you know, people that I respect, fellow Emerald Cup champions, Roger Baker, Joe DeRuzzi, Matt Loudon, you know, Mike Sedano, who doesn't compete anymore. Anybody that is local and has done well and they're encouraging to me and they believe in me, those things are way more motivating than any professional video or magazine or whatever that I could be inspired by. So just little things, people that you respect, they could say one word and I'll carry that for, you know, a whole prep. You know, they might not know that, but it's like a respect thing. So I'll be a heavy. I've been a heavy since my first year in Open. 2007 was my first year in the Open Men's Division. I've been a heavy ever since. Weight up until this point, I think my body is like really, it's holding weight really well. Like I said, I've been on water and fish, and my body is still at like 223, and it's not really giving. Once I drop water and dry out, I'll probably drop down to, you know, anywhere from 215 to 218 dry. But I've been a steady 223, 224, regardless of how low my calories have been and how much cardio I've done, so heavyweight. After the Emerald Cup, my sponsor, rxway.com, was supporting me in the Dexter Jackson Classic in August. I think it's like August 6th, which is going to be, 14 weeks after the Emerald Cup or something like that. So hopefully I can take maybe 4 weeks off, recuperate, let my body fill out, and then get back on the saddle again and dial it in for the Dexter Jackson, and support rxway.com because they've been great to me, and do the best I can. I heard it's a good show. If IFBB Bro puts on a venue, you know it's going to be awesome, good, well covered and whatnot. So that is the plan as of right now. I'd like to thank my sponsors, actually, rxway.com. That's the website, the company's prescription nutrition. They basically supply you with all your protein needs, and we're talking like every type of protein, micellar casein, fresh whey, hydrolyzed whey, Pepto-Pro, everything you can pretty much think of, and they're really affordable. They don't really believe in fancy marketing or advertising, so you aren't going to get a fancy label. You get quality ingredients in a bag. Simple as that. They back me. I would only back a company that's utmost quality because I have integrity and I wouldn't represent something just for the sake of them sponsoring me. And then also Quest Protein Bars, which is probably the best. It is the best quality bar on the market right now. I always tell people, when they're usually eating protein bars on a diet, it's like a cheat meal or a cheat food. This Quest bar is essentially having a whey isolate shake and a pack of raw almonds as a meal, but you get the texture of a bar. So incredible company. And then of course the company who I'm employed by, Primordial Performance, awesome company. Gotta thank them. They're supporting me. They're all coming up to the Emerald Cup to root me on, and I'm just blessed to have good company.